I'm really thankful for all the challenges that I've been through in my life so far, not only in the business, but at the beginning of my life in the US. I think it allowed me to appreciate more what I have today. You know, I know how it feels to make $20,000 in a whole year, but after hard work, dedication, consistency, and resilience, I also experienced the feeling of making that same amount of money in just 1 month.
I wanna leave my footprints on the sands of time. No, there was something that meant something that I left behind. When I leave this world, I'll leave no regrets. Leave something to remember so they won't forget I was here.
Oh my goodness, that's funny.
My name is Lucie Matsouaka. I was born in Cameroon, the country in Central Africa. I came into the U.S. 12 years ago, 7 months pregnant with my first child, and I had $60 in my purse. I came for the American dream, and to me, America was that place where you can get money from the floor or getting from the trees. You know, the America that we see on TV when we are overseas is totally different. We see on movie and we think everything is going to be soft and beautiful. But unfortunately, I realized that you had to work hard. I had to learn English. I took ESL classes. And I had to go through the frustration of knowing things and not being able to express myself. And that wasn't easy. And we had to eventually find jobs.
So my first job, I was a CNA, and I was working two jobs. My first salary was $10.25 an hour. I still remember that because that was my first income.
To me, it was good at the time. It was good because at least I could feed the kids. And but it wasn't enough. And I started to think, you know, you have to pay the rent. You have to buy a car, and I was living in Boston and it's snowing. I still remember taking the train and the bus and running and pushing the child to the stroller. My husband had a small job where he was making about $11 an hour also. So I remember we had to call each other and say, okay, I'm gonna wait for you at the next bus stop so you can give me the child and I go home with him. It was such a weird place to be. I found myself working sometimes 80 hours in a week. I couldn't see the kids when I wanted to see them anymore. I couldn't see the kids. I was working between four to five nights every single week. Never really spent any holiday with the family. Weekend, I was at work. Christmas, I was at work. Thanksgiving, I was at work. It was really painful. But you know, when you have children and you have some responsibilities, all you have to do is keep pushing. I remember my daughter she has asthma, and sometimes I would come back home, maybe in the middle of the night, I would cancel my shift and run home in the middle of the night just because she had an episode.
One thing hit me when my son, one day, I believe he was 4 or 5 years old, when he told me, "Mommy, when are we going to celebrate Christmas together?" Now, there's another episode in my life that really hit me really hard. You see, as an African woman, we are raised to take care of our parents when they get old and when they can't take care of themselves anymore. My father one day was struggling with buying his medication, and he was suffering, and he was very ill with Parkinson's disease, and he asked me for some support. And I remember saying with excitement, "I'm gonna help you. I'm gonna send you a Western Union." But unfortunately, after I hang up the phone, I checked my accounts online, and I realized that it was negative. That was, I believe, one of the worst days of my life. I remember just falling on my knees and literally crying and thinking, something is wrong here. Last week I actually worked 80 hours. How come I can't even afford $100 for someone who did everything for me and who took care of me when I was growing up? And that was an aha moment for me.
So these are little things that I started to say, you know what, Lucie, something has to change in your life.
There has to be another way. There has to be another way. It's not this, because when I look around, I see those people going like golfing on a Tuesday morning, and I'm thinking, what type of job do you have? But one day, I have a friend who calls me, and the conversation goes like this. I need you to become my customer. I mean, she was a teacher, and she says, I need you to become my customer. I just started this business, and I need your support.
So I took her website, I took a look at the product, the different product and service that she was marketing, and something hit me. And the next day I called her and I asked her one question. I said, tell me the truth. If I take your service, I become your customer, how's it going to benefit you? And her answer was, every single time you'll be paying your bills, I'll get paid. And to me it was a weird concept, because I didn't know about this. And she said it's called residual income. You're getting paid every single month for something that you do one time. That was it for me. It was a deal breaker for me. And I said to her, listen, just show me what to do. She was actually shocked with my reaction, but I was like, you know what? I work in nursing, in healthcare. If you work, you get paid. If you stop working, you stop getting paid. So to me, that was it for me. And I decided to open my own business.
And I finally decided to get started with my home-based business. I actually had to add it on top of what I was already doing, which is working 80 hours. So it was not an easy beginning. It was not easy at all. I had no clue what I was getting myself into. It was my first ever experience when it comes to any type of business. I had no clue it was a network marketing company. I was literally clueless, but what happened was I was hungry and I was sick and tired of being where I was.
Success for me never came overnight. When I started, I had a lot of barriers to break, I will say. Not only the language, the fact that I was uncomfortable in my own skin, I was shy. I was really in a bad place because I don't know a lot of people in this country. Now, in network marketing, you're dealing with people. There's no way around it.
When people hit their first obstacle in their business, the first thing that they tend to do is back away or give up and say, oh no, this is not for me. What they don't understand is maybe it could mean that there is something you need to learn in order for you to get to the next level. I was not coached the right way. I didn't have a mentor yet. In that type of business, you need a mentor. You need someone to teach you what to do the right way.
As I was watching the videos of and this, the lifestyle of the people who were not only in the same company I'm working with, but who had a lot of success, and I started to say to myself, listen, there has to be another way to do this. There has to be a way to... Maybe they know something I don't know. And I started to look. You see the difference here? So what I did was I decided to reach out. The beauty of this type of business is if you push hard enough, if you work it consistently, you will definitely see some results. When I built this business part-time, after 7 months only, I was able to walk away from one of the jobs that I was doing. But I realized that if I just put enough effort and enough time in this, I could definitely become financially free, which is what I did. And I had to push a little harder. I still remember when I got started, I had people telling me that I would never get to the top just because I had a heavy accent or just because I was not comfortable in my own skin. You know, how do I get to grow so much that I can teach what I do to thousands of people in the country and around the world, just by learning, listening to audiobooks. You know, you have to go to training. Of course, it's not going to be easy. Anything that it's worth having, it's not going to be easy. You have to push through. I
I feel that heavy responsibility in my heart now to teach people what I do. That's the reason why I travel from state to state. I teach people how to become successful, at least to my level. Of course, I still have a long way to go, but it is still a learning and an earning experience every single day. Network marketing is one of those professions where you never stop learning and you never stop growing. And I would say it's the best way to grow. It's actually the best way to grow. You never achieve success by yourself. Never. You know, there are people behind you. There are people pushing you. There are people who actually support you. My family has been behind me every single day. And, you know, my husband was the one helping, taking care of the kids while I was going to all the meetings and everything. And my kids are not only the reason why I push so hard, but they are also those who make me smile when I get home. I enjoy traveling a whole lot. I love, I just want to be free. I want to be able to go where I want to be when I just feel like it. You know, I have family in Europe, my sister is in France, and it's such a great feeling to know that I can just book a flight and say I'm going to Paris tomorrow, just because I choose to. And I don't have a boss to tell me that I have to ask the permission first or I have to take time off. You know, things like that, you know money's not everything. Money's not everything. It's the things that you can do with the money. It gives you options. It gives you the freedom to do the things that you desire from your heart. And, you know, I'm able to go around the country and support my organization, help them dream again and show them that it's possible for them. I help them, I train them, and I support them, I teach them the things that I learned over the past 6 years. You know, but I want to thank my team. I want to thank my entire organization and all the vice presidents that I have in my organization. I want to thank them and say, you know, your time is coming. You know, to my team, to people who just got started in their business, you know, it's just a matter of time. You know, stick around, do what you're supposed to do, push hard, you know, stay focused and learn the system and push hard. You know, stay focused. That's the key. Stay focused and never, ever allow anybody to tell you what you can or you cannot do. Believe in yourself. That's all I have to say.